Hello, friends. Hope you're all doing great, and we're here again with some very interesting updates for you. Today, we'll mainly cover two topics: SpaceX's first polar launch from Florida and ULA's aborted Delta IV heavy mission. On Sunday evening, SpaceX successfully launched another Falcon 9 rocket with a payload of 3 satellites from Cape Canaveral, Florida. However, the surprising news is that after the launch, the SpaceX rocket took an exceptional path to south, rather heading towards the eastward. This mission originally planned to head for the polar orbit, which is a path from Earth's north pole to the south pole. Now, this is very unusual to see a rocket lift off from the east coast Florida and head towards the south, but SpaceX's Falcon 9 made it possible. Since 1969, most of the rockets normally launched from the east coast Florida head eastward towards the equator. That way, rockets cover most of the ocean areas to get to space. U.S. polar rockets also have taken liftoff from the southern coast of California to fly over the open ocean while heading towards southward. The main reason is to keep rockets away from populated areas. On November 30, 1960, a Thor DM-21 rocket exploded before getting into the stratosphere, and a part of its fuselage killed a Cuban cow. Because of that, the rockets fly over the ocean far away from the land, until SpaceX's Falcon 9, carrying an Argentinian satellite, headed south after crossing over Florida's southeast coast and Cuba. In 2016, wildfires got close to the Vandenberg Air Force Base in California, which was the U.S.'s main polar launch site at that time to launch all polar rockets. The fire caused severe damage around the launch pad, resulted delaying a launch for 2 months. After that, the U.S. Air Force started planning to shift their polar launches to Cape Canaveral in Florida. The 45th Space Wing of Cape Canaveral then decided to cut down the number of launches and allow minimum number of rockets to fly polar missions with some restrictions. Officials of Cape Canaveral's Space Wing permitted those polar launches, which has an inbuilt automated flight terminating system, AFTS, that allows a rocket to terminate itself depending on the situation. SpaceX's Falcon 9 offers this special AFTS feature. As per that requirement, Falcon 9 is the only rocket that can fly from Florida to southward coast. SpaceX said Falcon 9 is designed with this self-destructing feature for safety purposes. If the rocket moves away from its path for some reason, or something goes wrong, then the rocket could self-destruct itself without any contact from the ground. After a successful launch, the rocket will be flying close to populated land. Keeping that in mind, any issues from the rocket must be handled immediately. It will overfly Cuba, but it'll be at an altitude that we're safe, just like when we're going north, Brigadier General Douglas Sheese, commander of the 45th Space Wing, said in a press call. As we get up into the northern part of North America, we start to overfly some islands as well, but we're at a safer altitude at that point. The commander of the 45th Space Wing assures people's safety as he stated that Falcon 9 followed the right path that will keep everyone safe. I know that we're meeting all the requirements now, and it really comes down to being at the right altitude and speed at that time, to make sure that any debris that were to fall would be small enough and not even impact any land, which makes this ability to launch that from a safe perspective. There is a possibility that gases coming from the rocket's engines could interfere with signals that are sent to self-destruct the rocket. In that case, Falcon 9 must blow itself. It's the feature that allows SpaceX to take polar launches from Florida's ground. The community assures SpaceX's future flights will also have this autonomous flight terminating system. SpaceX planned a double Falcon 9 launch last weekend, one with polar mission and another one carrying 60 SpaceX Starlink satellite broadband. SpaceX Starlink launch originally scheduled for Sunday morning from NASA's 39A Kennedy Space Center. After finishing all the launch preparations, SpaceX's team finally shut down the launch because of incompatible weather conditions. According to the latest updates, the community decided to reschedule the launch for Thursday, September 3rd. In Cape Canaveral Air Force Station, weather conditions were also poor with medium rainfall and lightning. After canceling the previous SpaceX Starlink launch, SpaceX was focused for its Falcon 9 polar launch. At 7:18 p.m., weather showed slight improvements, which was enough to launch SpaceX's Falcon 9. The rocket took its final countdown, and at that exact moment, it lifted off from Florida's ground. Falcon 9 was carrying a SAOCOM 1B, an Argentinian satellite, as the main payload, along with two other satellites, GNOMES 1 and TYVAC 0172. SAOCOM 1B satellite deployed 14 minutes after the rocket was launched, while exactly 1 hour for the other two satellites after the launch. The SAOCOM, Satellites for Observation and Communications, is a two-satellite program worth $600 million, including launches. This mission, previously scheduled for March 2020, had been delayed due to the global pandemic. 2 years ago, SpaceX's Falcon 9 also launched previous SAOCOM satellite, SAOCOM 1A, from Vandenberg Air Force Station, SLC-4E. Both of the satellites launched into a polar orbital trajectory to fly over the Earth's poles. But SAOCOM 1B is the only satellite that launched into the polar orbital trajectory from Cape Canaveral Space Launch Complex, while first stage of Falcon 9 landed safely on the ground. SpaceX completed its 15th launch of 2020 as the two-staged reusable rocket took off the ground. After successfully deploying all three satellites, first stage of the rocket touched the landing zone 1 in Cape Canaveral. SpaceX's Falcon 9 previously completed two Dragon cargo missions. These two missions launched the Dragon 1 resupply capsule for International Space Station. Including this mission, B-1059, the first stage rocket booster, completes a second trip, as this booster previously landed to the same place after delivering CRS-20 mission into orbit. For landing on the firm ground, the booster detached from its upper stage, managing its position while floating in the sky. Finally, a series of three engine burns gently landed it on the ground. SpaceX uses two drone ships named Of Course I Still Love You and Just Read the Instructions to recover most of its rocket boosters. When the boosters are back in Florida's port, SpaceX sends to the main facility for inspection and reuse again. Now let's have a look at some updates regarding ULA's Delta IV heavy launch getting scrubbed for the second time. An unexpected reason caused the United Launch Alliance to abort its two-staged beast. According to the timeline, the rocket is previously scheduled to lift off on the 30th of August, which was Saturday, at 2:04 a.m. But a high temperature reading from the rocket delayed the countdown to 3:28 a.m. Unfortunately, the community had to abort the liftoff just 3 seconds before the final countdown reaches zero. This would have been a fascinating scene if the rocket had liftoff from Cape Canaveral's ground. Usually, just before the launch, the three orange boosters of Delta IV Heavy gets covered by fire, though the same happened this time, but without noticing the engine never started. The crew announced liftoff. Later, ULA director announced that the launch had been called off. The Delta IV Heavy rocket is one of the most powerful rockets in the ULA that's completed a number of most expensive missions for National Reconnaissance Office, NRO, and NASA. Previously, the rocket successfully launched NASA's Parker Sola probe from Cape Canaveral launch site. According to ULA, this would have been the 8th Delta Heavy launch for NRO missions. ULA's Delta IV Heavy did not lift off, as the reason for launch failure later came out as a hot fire abort, according to the ULA officials. Before this launch, ULA presented the first ever 3D projection for its Delta IV Heavy rocket. And to celebrate United Launches Alliance legacy of 140 successful mission. The presentation started, followed by a countdown of Delta IV Heavy rocket. Later, the projection showed Delta IV Heavy virtually lifted off from the ground, while the background keeps changing according to the current scenario. It's the first time an actual rocket used as a background. This idea came from the CEO of United Launch Alliance, Tory Bruno, himself. Though it was unclear what the exact problem was, it would take at least a week to get prepared for relaunch. As mentioned earlier, it should not collide with any SpaceX launch planned for Cape Canaveral. SpaceX also had a plan to launch a Starlink mission earlier in the day, but due to bad weather, it was rescheduled. The way that ULA aborted the launch was very dramatic as well as rare. This type of failure often illustrates the reason behind why rocket manufacturer companies organize so many tests, why they take test flights before the actual launch. That's all from our side, my friends. We'll soon be back with more updates. So be with us to catch the latest updates. Till then, stay safe, take care, and goodbye. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.